Leader of the National Democratic Congress in Parliament, Haruna Iddrisu, is worried about why ministers who are yet to be passed by Parliament are acting in various capacities already. His concern follows the President's instruction to some ministers who served in his first term to continue in acting positions. These former ministers include Ken Oforiatta, who was the Minister for Finance, Alan Chiramanteng, who was the Minister for Trade, and the Minister for Local Government, Hajah Alima Mahama, and former Information Minister, Kojo Opong Nkrumah. Here's me speaking to Daniel Dazi.
I've seen some ministers still hold themselves about as if they are ministers. That is unlawful, that is illegal, that is unconstitutional. As we speak today, there is no minister in Ghana.
And therefore, we understand, has asked them to act.
No.
There is the president has asked them to
No, he got it wrong. Go and read the succinct ruling in J.H. Mensah versus Attorney General, 1997 Supreme Court ruling. Their mandate have lapsed. Until they are nominated, go through vetting, prior approval of parliament, they cannot hold themselves out as ministers. The same J.H. Mensah of New Patriotic Party questioned it when Kwame Peperenko were asked to follow through. So, I mean, there's a Presidential Transition Act. The president must be law-abiding, rule of law. As far as we are concerned, there's nothing like acting minister. Mm. The Supreme Court ruling does not recognize an acting minister.
So what will the minority do about
this? And I say the Supreme Court ruling, J.H. Mensah versus Attorney General, I have a copy, I'll read to you, does not recognize any person purporting to hold himself as minister and wanting to exercise the authority and mandate of a minister. Their time have lapsed. That is why it's interesting. What happened in parliament, we saw some ministers have been pointed that they give command to soldiers or military or police at that material time at midnight. There was no minister for defense, there was no minister for interior. Whoever gave that authority acted unlawfully and would hold him accountable to that.
So you're going to follow through authority. The
I say there will be an inquiry to understand some people's conduct and whether that conduct is acceptable in a democracy, that a sitting member of parliament can run away and even swallow ballot papers already thumbprinted.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. So, Mr. Iddrisu, what specific action is your side of parliament going to do and your party going to do about the president's directive to the ministers to act?
The president is wrong in law and his conduct is unconstitutional. He should be the last person to be acting in breach of the law, particularly when the Supreme Court ruling in J.H. Mensah versus Attorney General 1997 said that there can be no minister and there's nothing like a holding minister until that minister is nominated with the prior approval of parliament. I'm not aware that parliament has approved any person to hold himself. What the Presidential Transition Act provides is that you hand over to the heads of bureaucracy, the chief directors, to run it until side time that ministers are properly vetted. Mm. But you cannot say they should go and hold on to it. So you see MPP, double tongue. In 1997, they saw everything wrong with it. Now that they are in power, bless you, God.
But I remember that in 2016.
And that's how we end the AM News with me, Mapisa Sibiri.